Sandeep Patil, the Managing Director of IBM India and South Asia, joins us. Mr. Patil, thanks very much for being with us. Now, the weather company is an IBM business, and it's something which, in a country like ours, has a direct impact on the lives of farmers in terms of the produce, in terms of weather conditions in a particular area. Give us an idea of how this particular service involves and assists our farmers across India on a monthly basis.
Sure. So look, farmers are essentially looking for two types of information. One is accurate rain forecast that enables them to decide when and how much to irrigate. And secondly, understand the impact of weather on potential risks to crop health, right? And this is the way they can take informed preemptive decisions. And to do this, they need short-term forecasts, and they need this information at a hyper-local sub-acre level. And this is where, we are doing things which we are calling precision agriculture. So it's a set of solutions. One is by combining multiple global satellite-based information sources with weather company data to compute actionable agronomic insights for individual farmers at a sub-acre level. And we are doing this in conjunction with the Ministry of Agriculture. We've done it in four districts already, Rajkot, Nanded, Bhopal, and Varanasi. And in addition to that, this information is required in short-term interval forecasts. And to do that, we are leveraging IBM's supercomputing model called IBM Graph, coupled with weather company data, to bring short-term forecasts in India. And this is the way we can enable farmers to turn the unanticipated to envisioned and enable them to take preemptive decisions.
And Mr. Patil, how can people like food aggregators, processors, distributors, how can they use technology to make supply chains resilient and also future-proof?
So look, the key issue in making supply chains a lot more resilient is the timely access to the right data and the kind of data that actually is required to and which impacts demand and supply cycles in agri-food chains are things like, what is growing where, the appropriate farm price for the produce, what is the timely access for processing and distribution centers. So this is the kind of information that's required. And this is where technologies like artificial intelligence, blockchain, IoT, remote sensing, cloud can actually help to bridge this gap by providing accurate weather forecasts, citizen information that is pushed out through mobile apps, using trusted artificial intelligence for farm level decision making. And there are several others. But let me give you a very specific example. Mm-hmm. So we have been working with the Karnataka Agriculture Price Commission in the area of tomato production, right? And what we have done is developed with them an advanced first-of-a-kind price forecasting system, which is a dashboard leveraging IBM's Watson decision platform for agriculture, as well as big data, artificial intelligence, machine learning, et cetera. And it does two things. One, it assesses the acreage and monitors crop health on a real-time basis. Mm-hmm. And second, it predicts market level price trends for at least a fortnight and then aligns it with the production pattern of tomatoes. So this is, again, an example where technology can be leveraged to provide timely, accurate, relevant information and data to enable better decisions and sort of save any wastage in food production.
Yeah, and real-time data, and that's so important to get information on a real-time basis. Thank you very much, Mr. Patil, for being with us.